all of you are probably aware that this is our fourth destination in attempting to interact with tax administrators all over the country. The Prime Minister had very clearly said during the Independence Day speech from the Red Fort, and also after that when he has addressed some newspapers, and said how clearly this country values, whatever be the size, small, medium, micro, nano or large, entrepreneurs of this country. We want them to, without a worry, carry on with their business. Similarly, we have expressed our keenness to serve the cause of farmers, so that everyone carries on with their business, which essentially creates jobs, which creates wealth for the country. And therefore, it was important that the tax administrators facilitated them. It was important that tax administrators do their job of tax collection, enforcement of tax rules, but necessarily understanding business and going with them, facilitating them. So, in order that we communicated this to all our tax authorities, we have undertaken this trip from mostly the tier 2 cities, not metropolitan towns. So there, in the process of meeting with the tax administrators, the revenue secretary, the CBIC chairman, and also the CBDT chairperson accompanies me, the principal commissioners in that area, the chief commissioner of GST and customs, the principal commissioners of income tax also come in, but the entire tax administrators are invited to have this interaction. So that is what happened today. After that, we have interacted also with the associations, trade bodies, trade associations, chartered cost accountants and their associations, and heard from them issues that they wanted us to hear. Now we are meeting with the press. Can I please have questions related to this visit first, and then I'll address. Uske baad mein aati hoon.
Madam, what were the concerns raised by trade associations, especially when it comes to Pune and Pimpri-Chinchwad as well, which is one of the major auto hubs in the country?
Well, first of all, today the meeting was after my having announced all that the government wants to do. And that announcement itself came after consulting all sectors which wanted to meet us. And that included the automobile and automotive components sector also. So that specific question that you asked me about that particular thing was already part of the consultation we had, and after that came the announcement also. So today largely people who were here were more focusing on GST forms related matters, deadline related matters, simplification of the forms in GST matters, and also about home buyers, about industry in general, and matters like that. And there were other sectors which also wanted to have GST rates brought down. So largely today trade and industry association confined to these matters.
So, regarding the deadline of the income tax return, specifically related to Sangli and Kolhapur, which was submerged recently.
But that was already included in the announcement that the revenue secretary had made for all flood affected districts, not just of Maharashtra, but of Karnataka, Kerala, Uttarakhand, and Himachal Pradesh. So, that was already made. That announcement was already made.
The income tax return date is extended you can,
that was
not yet that.
No, no, the income tax return, the last date was July 31st.
How
and that has been extended, that has been extended to 31st. So far the GST is concerned, the GST, the last date was August 20th, which we have extended for 1 month for the flood affected areas. Whereas in the income tax, we are already on the extended date. So most of the people who have already filed the tax returns on before 31st July, only the few remaining people would have been required to file the tax return in August. And that the last date is 31st of August.
No, specifically Sangli Kolhapur area, I'm talking.
All the flood affected areas is what I'm referring to.
Can you elaborate on tax administrators should understand businesses while doing tax administration? What do you mean by that?
I mean that they don't need to overstretch. Sorry. I mean that in order to achieve the targets which are given to them, which is done every year, it's not something which only our government is doing. Since the time tax collection is on the earth, there are deadlines given and they collect. What I have said is the deadlines which have been given, not just in today's meeting, in all meetings, have all been decided in consultation with all the authorities. So they are not impossible deadlines. They are achievable deadlines, realistic deadlines. And therefore, my request was not to overreach, not to overstate themselves in the collection process. It was achievable, even if they were able to go with a bit of a rest rate. That's what I did.
मैम जीएसटी इम्प्लीमेंटेशन के बाद एमएसएमई सेक्टर का बहुत लंबा समय से एक कंसर्न चल रहा था जो सेटलमेंट का जो अभी हाल में जो घोषणा भी सरकार की तरफ से की गई माना गया कि एमएसएमई सेक्टर को एक रिलीफ मिलेगा ऐसा लगता है कि ये रिलीफ पहले दिया जा सकता था इतनी थोड़ी देर हो गई जो उनका जो जीएसटी सेटलमेंट है तो मेन कंसर्न उनका था जीएसटी का
मैं एक अनाउंसमेंट पिछले शुक्रवार को की उसमें इस विषय में मैं एक क्लियर कट आश्वासन दिलाई कि अब तक की पेंडिंग जितनी भी है वो 30 दिन के अंदर दिया जाता है और अब से लेकर के जो भी पेमेंट्स होगा वो 60 डेज के अंदर क्लियर हो जाएगा ये स्टेटमेंट मैंने पिछले फ्राइडे को कर दिया
Based on the interactions, the inputs you had from the people in this region, basically this is predominantly agri-commodities area of Maharashtra. Is there any implementable point that you have got and you are likely to, you know, implementing?
Particularly on agri product, there was nothing mentioned.
Okay.
So they are not filing the returns, and also the percentage of the people are also declined. These are the tax findings, and these inputs. That report are tabled on, I think, 13th or 4th July. So, do you think that there is need of more changes in GST implementation?
Well, I'm not sure I'll be able to comment on the CAG's report now. I need to go through it and then maybe I can comment. Unless it's Revenue Secretary comes to it.
But it's tabled on 13th of July in Parliament.
Unless I go through it, I won't be able to give you a comment. The ministry has to go through it after the check. उसके लिए क्या उसका उपयोग कैसे होगा इस विषय में तो मैं अभी कुछ बोल नहीं सकती हम निर्णय लेंगे उसके बाद आपको जानकारी
मैम वन ऑफ द डिमांड्स ऑफ द ऑटो
सेक्टर
मुझे जब भी राहुल गांधी जी चोरी चोर ये सब बातें उठाते हैं ना एक विषय आता वो बहुत प्रयत्न किए चोर चोर चोरी चोरी बोलकर जनता ने उसको सटीक जवाब दिया उसके बाद भी वही शब्दों को मैं उपयोग करूंगा इससे क्या निकलता है कांग्रेस पार्टी कम से कम रिजर्व बैंक के मामले में उनके यहां जरूर भी फिनांस मिनिस्टर्स थे जितने भी सीनियर्स थे उन सब से बात करने के बाद उनका आरोप फिर भी वो चोर कहने के विषय में तो अभी माहिर हो गए हैं इसलिए मैं उसको इतना भरवा नहीं करूँगा
मैं
what I want to tell you about whether it is this or whether it is any agreed commodity about which nothing was discussed. GST rate reduction. I am willing to hear any number of people, any number of sectors, any number of whoever wants to talk on GST rates. But it is not in my hand. It has to go to the GST Council. Ministers from all the states are the members in the council. It has to be discussed there. There are fitment committees which will analyze it. Legal committee, is it? They will, law committee, which will have to look at it. So decision is made there through a process. So
after the Vimal Jalan committee recommendation and RBI board, will you still consider the sovereign bond the fundraising by the sovereign bond because you are getting the 1,57,000 crores?
Yeah, but what is the connection that you're drawing? I didn't say in the budget that depending on what Vimal Jalan committee will do, I'm proposing to bring. They were not connected.
No, it's not connected. But you are getting the money. That's why the base.
No, that's all right. That's already that's a call which we've announced in the budget. That's a call which the government will
make. Madam, you are doing your best. Like, but do you think that is the
I've announced some measures for the automobile sector. I'd have to see how it goes. I'll also have to take input from the sector as to for what kind of an impact the announcements which were already made have had. And only then can I take it.
You are trying to the best. Do you think that the
Ramnath Rajan has said that the RBI's international credit rating will be affected and has reduced the surplus by transferring the bond.
I am not responding to anybody in particular, but I want to say that the Vimal Jalan committee had eminent experts in it. It was constituted by the Reserve Bank themselves and not by the government. They have had several sittings and have said or have come out with a formula. Like the committees which looked at the excess capital framework earlier. So this is a committee which the Reserve Bank appointed, had experts. They have given a formula based on which the amount is arrived. Now any suggestion about the credibility of the Reserve Bank, therefore for me, seems a bit outlandish, if I may use that word, considering the committee was appointed by the Reserve Bank themselves. They have themselves given an explanation yesterday, I think, to some media reports that financial stability, surplus to meet any emergency and contingency have all been factored in by the committee when they arrived at the formulation of a formula. So, comments being given on the credibility of the Reserve Bank, I'm afraid, is commenting on the Reserve Bank itself and their selection of the committee itself and their arriving, the committee independently arriving at a formula itself. And therefore, being a part of the government, strictly may not be my business to talk about it, but it's very worrying that a committee appointed by the Reserve Bank of experts who have had several meetings and have come with a formulation is now being questioned.
Are you going to remove the import duty?